Highbridge, a division of Recorded Books, presents From Earth Z with Love by Ramy Vance and Michael Anderle. Read by Gabriel Vaughan. Chapter 1. Earth Z, where the twisted older Rueben Z is from.
Run! Rueben Z shouted. What have you gotten us into?
Rueben yelled as he concentrated on hopping across the tops of the cars across the street. Rueben Z was in front of him, leading the way, and Buzz was behind him, panting. Some of the car roofs and hoods dented when they stepped on them. One time, Buzz cried out behind Rueben and almost fell, but Rueben caught him, and together they rushed forward after Rueben Z. Behind them, the sloughing sound of dust continued to slide over the empty cars lining the New York City street like a dry waterfall.
This was supposed to be a simple sample grab, Buzz said. Not a horror movie.
Can we kill that thing?
Rueben yelled. He gripped a semi-automatic rifle, but he wasn't about to turn and use it when he needed to focus on running. Rueben Z called over his shoulder as he leapt to the next car.
Nah, but bullets hurt it. Once we chase it off, you can grab your sample.
Buzz gulped.
We're gonna die.
Up ahead, on the sidewalk on the other side of the car-clogged street, Rueben Z abruptly stopped and turned, tilting his machine gun up.
No one's dying today.
He gritted his teeth as his gun spat bullets. Rueben grabbed Buzz by the wrist and yanked him off the last car and onto the sidewalk. Buzz gasped.
That man is crazy.
Rueben sucked in air as he stopped to glance back at the monster pursuing them. His mind referred to it as a monster because that's what it looked like, a giant panther of dust with hollow eye sockets and teeth and claws. It didn't move like a monster, though. It was too fast, too fluid. It cascaded over the tops of the cars like a raging rapid. Before that, it had descended from the sky like a storm cloud, a massive, sentient storm cloud. Rueben considered raising his rifle, but he didn't trust his aim after sprinting over the cars. As Rueben and Buzz caught their breath and glanced behind them, Rueben Z's bullets punched into the dust monster in a roaring stream. Dust-like material sprayed up from the monster's skin where the slugs impacted, and its giant, beast-like head writhed and turned as it approached. The thing took up nearly the entire width of the street. It was huge.
Can you explain this?
Rueben shouted to Buzz as he gripped his best friend's shirt and tugged him down an alley. He could shoot later if he had a chance to rest for a moment. Now it was in their best interest to keep moving.
Is it alive?
Buzz shook his head.
It shouldn't be. This is amazing.
And pants-shittingly terrifying.
Rueben breathed hard as they ran down the alley. The gunfire behind them had stopped, only to be replaced by Rueben Z shouting for them to run faster.
The virus, Buzz continued, out of breath, must have found a way to transmute into different forms, based on how it interacts with Rueben Z's blood, and how it feeds on time warps. Who only knows how many times it's mutated since it first devoured this Earth?
Rueben Z sprinted between them and threw his arms out wide to grab Rueben and Buzz by the shoulders. He must have tossed his machine gun to the side when he ran out of bullets.
Keep moving. It's wounded.
Rueben snuck a glance over his shoulder.
Doesn't look like it.
As he said that, he noticed the black goo trailing down the creature's dusty hide. Was it the monster's version of blood? Rueben Z smirked.
Oh, I heard it. It's pissed.
Then Rueben Z retracted his hands from Rueben's and Buzz's shoulders and sprinted ahead of them, not winded in the slightest.
Try to keep up. We've got it on the run.
Buzz and Rueben exchanged glances and struggled to pick up their pace.
That future parallel version of you is a real badass, Buzz said.
I know. I kind of hate him.
Rueben might have been a time warper, but he was also lanky and out of shape. This was the longest alley ever.
I'm going to start running after all this is over.
From ahead of them, near the end of the alley, Rueben Z called,
My grandma runs faster than the two of you combined, and she's dead.
Rueben considered stopping, raising his rifle and blowing the man away, or lobbing one of the grenades jangling in his pockets. Buzz awkwardly cradled the pistol in his hand as he ran beside him. Judging by the look on his face, the scientist was thinking the same thing.
This is why I don't go in the field, Buzz said. From here on out, I'm staying in the lab.
Oh, come on, Rueben said between panting breaths, snapping out of his funk. You enjoy this a little. We're basically superheroes.
I'm not the one who can warp backward in time if we die.
Are you forgetting that I can't warp now? Now that we know the monster feeds on time warps?
We don't know if it feeds on time warps. Only Rueben Z's time warps because he's infected. I have to run some more tests to confirm first. When I get back to the safety of my lab.
They rounded the corner at the end of the alley and came out on a sidewalk. Rueben Z had stopped there and waved them on while he pulled out two grenade pins with his teeth and spat them to the side.
Take that, he grunted as he tossed the grenades,
then annoyingly caught back up to Buzz and Rueben as if it was nothing.
How much farther do we have to run?
Rueben tried to keep up with Rueben Z as they raced down the sidewalk. Twin explosions rocked the city behind them, and a monstrous howl split the air.
Not much farther. There's a place up ahead where we can make our last stand.
Buzz gasped.
Last stand? This wasn't supposed to be a suicide mission.
Oh, I don't plan on dying, Rueben Z said. Between the three of us, we have enough firepower to scare that thing off. See, I think it feels pain, the same as us.
Rueben shook his head.
How? And why does it bleed?
Rueben Z cracked his knuckles.
If it bleeds, we can kill it, he said in an Arnold Schwarzenegger accent.
Rueben's eyes widened. Earth Z has an Arnold Schwarzenegger?
You mean the Terminator? Hell yeah. In our universe, he becomes president.
Rueben Z scratched his chin.
Come to think of it, that could still happen on Earth A.
Buzz shook his head.
Focus, guys. To answer your question, I don't know why it bleeds. Evolution shit. My best guess, the time virus found a way to manipulate the dead dust cells of the withered life it killed, then developed a sense of unity or hive consciousness, or something.
I'm no scientist, Rueben said, but that's not how viruses work.
Buzz coughed to clear his throat.
I am a scientist. Sometimes discoveries are made and science contradicts itself.
Rueben Z scoffed. In case you haven't noticed, this ain't your garden variety virus. Pretty sure it was man-made. It's the only thing that makes sense.
Rueben shook his head. Sounds too science fiction-y to me.
I don't know, Buzz said. It would make sense if the designer of the virus was familiar with repeaters. But only a handful of people know about repeaters, let alone how their time-warping powers work.
They were approaching an overturned semi lying perpendicular to the street. Behind it, a row of crashed cars formed a makeshift step up to the semi's long metal flank. Rueben Z climbed atop it.
Enough talk, boys. Time to blow shit up.
The dust monster was nowhere in sight, but judging by its agonized howl, it was still coming for them, careening down the alley. They all clambered up on top of the overturned semi and waited, crouching as they laid out their extra gun magazines and grenades before them. The grenades all had a tiny yellow LED on them. Were these some kind of special Earth-Z grenades? Even with all the weapons at their disposal, Rueben doubted they could wound the monster enough to make it flee. From their spot, it was a good 100 yards to the alley's opening, and they had a perfect view of the entire length.
Catch your breath while you can. Don't fire until you have a good shot. We can't afford to waste any ammo.
Rueben Z looked like a mercenary or soldier as he unslung the two submachine guns from his shoulders and trained them down the street. Rueben was glad the man was here, but not so much about the part about Rueben Z knowing what they were walking into when they arrived here.
Why didn't you tell us?
Tell you what? Rueben Z growled.
He set down one of his guns to line up his grenades on the surface in front of him.
About the frigging monster that awaited us when we traveled back here.
Rueben Z shrugged.
Oh, that. Well, you needed a sample of the super-evolved virus. That thing has your sample.
It's a sentient monster dust cloud.
Meh, an obstacle to overcome. Nothing more.
An obstacle? Rueben said.
A bestial howl erupted from the alley's opening. Buzz glanced down at the pistol shaking in his hands.
Rueben Z grunted. It's not gonna bite you. The safety is already off. All you gotta do is point and aim, and pull the trigger.
Buzz gulped.
Line up the top sights, and you got this. I've seen your shooting before. Well, this Earth's version of you. You're a natural killer.
Rueben flashed Buzz a look to show his agreement.
It's coming.
Buzz's words were soft. Rueben Z picked up his other submachine gun.
Look alive, boys.
Earth A, where our Rueben is from.
You think I'm paranoid, don't you?
Aki shook her head, turned her attention away from Martha, and returned to the live satellite feed she was viewing in Buzz's lab.
No, it's just that they've only been gone for a few minutes.
Martha sighed.
You're probably right. I'm sure they have everything under control.
Of course. Aki drummed her fingers on the desk. Rueben and Buzz are accompanied by a parallel Earth 20 years older Rueben doppelganger that we've very uncreatively named Rueben Z.
Ugh.
Martha grabbed her head in her hands.
Now you have me worried about that variable. You don't think Rueben Z will try anything funny, do you? There's no way to tell.
Aki's smirk tightened as her eyes focused on a portion of the satellite feed showing the Catskill Mountains in upstate New York. With pursed lips, she zoomed in on a cluster of trees on one of the green-covered rocky slopes.
Oh, shit.
Martha leaned in over Aki's shoulder for a better look at the screen.
Did the time virus escape the lab after all? I don't know.
A cluster of trees gently swayed as if swept by a strong wind. Martha nudged Aki's shoulder.
What are we looking at, besides trees?
They both watched for a few moments, but nothing happened.
I don't know. I guess it was nothing. Well, what do you think you saw?
Aki sighed.
I thought I saw some trees disintegrating. You know, withering away into dust, like how we saw in Buzz's greenhouse experiment. And?
Martha prodded.
You can see for yourself. There's no rampant spreading, no outward expanding circle of withering death. I think we're in the clear.
Aki wiped her forehead while Martha continued to stare at the screen.
These trees on the side do look a little funny, almost like a part of them was chopped off.
Aki chuckled nervously.
Don't take this the wrong way, but I think we're seeing things.
Martha stared for a bit longer at the odd-looking trees and drew a deep breath. She stood to her full height, then sank into a chair.
Yeah.
The two women sat in silence for a few minutes, watching the satellite feed and seeing no sign of the virus. Even if they did see the virus activity, there wasn't much they could do. The virus was all-consuming and fed on all living things, instantly withering them and rendering them to dust. If the virus had somehow survived, this world was done for. Aki continued their conversation as if they hadn't had an interruption.
There's nothing to worry about. They all took Buzz's time virus vaccine. According to Rueben Z, Earth Z is all dust. What's the worst that can happen to them?
Martha sighed.
Yeah, you're probably right. I'm sure they have everything under control.
Chapter 2. Earth Z. With a screeching cry, the monster burst from the mouth of the alley. It had to condense itself to fit through the alley, but it now enlarged as it emerged. Dust scraped off the sides of the passage, sprinkling to the sidewalk and asphalt like sloughed-off dead skin. Maybe it was only Rueben, but he thought he saw tentacles flapping above the monster's back and sides. The monster's hollowed-out eye sockets tightened as they locked in on their position. Then it opened its dark, dusty maw and howled. It surged forward.
"That form!"
Buzz said hurriedly, his scientist's brain taking over as he gripped the pistol in a two-handed grip.
"How curious that the virus is posing as a Cthulhu panther or something."
"Let's save the philosophical waxing for the after-party, shall we?" Rueben Z said. "Now fire!" They let loose with everything they had, and for what it appeared, their shots were taking a toll on the beast. Black goo spilled out from the wounds that racked its dusty hide. It pressed onward. Rueben fired his rifle with precise shots, striking the monster in the facial area. He hit it in the nose, the cheek, the forehead, and even in the eye socket. Rueben Z's spray of submachine gun fire ripped along the creature's bulging neck, shoulders, and front legs, while Buzz was firing away at the incoming monster, most likely missing with each shot, even considering the monster's size. It was now almost halfway to them. It was moving much slower than it had been, almost dragging itself along. Were they going to be able to defeat it? The first to run out of ammo was Rueben Z. He deftly reloaded each submachine gun and then brought one up to begin firing again. Buzz's handgun emptied next, but the genius didn't seem to notice as he kept pulling the trigger long after he'd run out. When Rueben's rifle emptied, he ejected the magazine and shoved in a replacement, firing until the creature started to get dangerously close to their position. Still, it charged toward them in sporadic limps and bursts of speed. Although wounded, the beast threw up its head and blasted them with an enraged howl that made Buzz drop his gun.
"Shit,"
Rueben muttered. Maybe this fight wasn't almost over after all. He had reached the end of his second magazine when Rueben Z called, "Grenade time!" Black goo drenched the monster's entire front side. It screamed and pushed on. Rueben Z ripped out the pins from two grenades and lobbed them into the monster's path. Rueben did the same, hoping that Buzz wouldn't fumble and blow them up. They had only one shot at this, or else Rueben would have to warp back in time, and he didn't know if that was safe yet or not. Rueben Z threw two more grenades. Buzz managed to fling one, but it was such a terrible throw it was comical, even given the dire circumstances. Chuckling, Rueben Z continued to chuck grenades. Rueben and Buzz did their best to keep up. Directly in front of them, the monster was nearly right on them, its torso and back end trailing back to the alley it was so big. Dark tendrils whipped wildly above its body like something from a nightmare. Suddenly, Rueben realized that none of the grenades had gone off yet. Were they defective? With the monster looming up right in front of them now, they were screwed. Rueben Z turned to them and ordered in a drill instructor's intense tone, "Get the fuck down!" The grenades went off seemingly all as one, as the monster's head swooped over the semi right toward them. Rueben clenched his teeth. Then his body was shoved sideways off the semi as about a ton of dust collapsed upon him and Buzz and Rueben Z, completely burying them on the street below. Dust covered the street like a dune. A moment later, Ruben's hand shot up through the pile. His fingers searched the air as another hand reached down and gripped the flailing wrist, ripping Rueben up from the grainy depths. Rueben coughed to expel the dust from his lungs as he watched Rueben Z calmly drop to his knees and start digging beside where Rueben had been. Eventually, Rueben Z glanced up at Rueben, irritation on his face. "You gonna help?"
"Buzz."
Rueben dropped and started to scoop the dust aside. It wasn't long until they uncovered Buzz's shoulder and arm. With a grunt, Rueben Z grabbed Buzz under the arm and hauled him up and on top of the dune. Black goo spotted the giant dust pile. Fortunately, it didn't have a smell, considering it was a mass of withered, dead organisms infected by the time virus. Buzz sat up and sputtered, spitting out a glob of the black goo.
"What the hell is this stuff?"
he whined. "The virus's equivalent of blood," Rueben Z said.
"It's messed up, is what it is."
Buzz straightened his shirt collar. Then, childlike glee showed in his eyes as he ran his hands through the dune.
Wait, what am I saying? This is incredible. I must study it.
His words cut off as Rueben Z smacked him on the top of the head like a misbehaving dog.
No time. Grab a sample, quick.
Huh? What's the rush?
Buzz said.
The monster's gone.
The dust pile they were standing in was starting to shiver. Rueben shook his head.
Looks like we're still in that horror movie after all. I'm gonna be sick.
Buzz drew a glass vial with a locking rubber cap on it from his pocket. Luckily, it hadn't broken. He wasted no time in scooping up some of the dust into the vial, twisting the cap back on, and pulling the extra rubber cover down over the seal. The dust all around them no longer shivered, but tremored like an earthquake. Rueben turned to Rueben Z.
Now what? We fight it all over again?
Rueben Z scoffed.
I don't know about you, but I'm down to my combat knife.
No, we run.
Run?
Buzz and Rueben both whined.
Back to the space and time capsule. Follow me.
They reached the space and time capsule, a metal and glass dimension-traveling vehicle reminiscent of something out of Superman. It would take them back to Earth A and safety, for the moment at least. They popped the lid and climbed inside as the dust monster howled from a few blocks behind them. They were strapping themselves in when the monster burst around the street corner and rushed toward them in a giant, writhing mass.
Where are we going?
Rueben asked as he shut the lid above them with a click. Beside him, Rueben Z punched in a command on the center console. The capsule started to vibrate. Through the glass lid, the time virus monster hurtled toward them in the shape of a massive, sharp-toothed jaw. The vehicle winked out of existence. Earth A. The lid clicked open, and the fluorescent light of Buzz's lab washed over them. As Rueben climbed out, Buzz was saying,
"Oh, home sweet home,"
over and over again. Rueben stumbled out and caught himself against the side of the capsule as Aki rushed over to him.
"Are you okay?"
The warmth of her hand steadying him felt so comforting.
"Yeah, we're fine."
"You're bleeding."
Aki pointed at Ruben's scraped arms and cheek. She straightened his shirt, and dust fell to the lab floor.
"What is that?"
"Oh, only the time virus."
Rueben ran a hand back through his hair.
"We kind of got attacked."
He whipped his gaze over at Rueben Z, who had silently exited the space and time capsule and was rummaging through his futuristic body armor laid out on one of the lab tables. Aki gave Rueben an incredulous look.
"There were survivors on Earth Z?"
"The time virus is the only survivor,"
Buzz clarified. He raised a hand.
"Don't ask me the specifics right now, or why there was oxygen for us to breathe without any trees. I have much to study."
"Study?"
Rueben said.
"You're not coming back to Earth Z with Rueben Z and me to collect the Ground Zero virus sample?"
"Fuck that."
Buzz lovingly cradled the sample of the super-evolved virus in his hands.
"I think you two have it covered."
Rueben glanced down at the dust filtering onto the lab's floor from their clothes.
"Speaking of being covered, this stuff isn't going to come to life, right?"
Buzz scratched his head and studied the vial in his hand. The dust sample was swirling around violently inside the glass. He turned his gaze back to the dust on the floor, which looked like dust.
"Guess not. The world hop must have reverted the active virus to dormant, or maybe it killed it outright since the Earth Z host was already dead."
"So creepy,"
Martha said, entering the room.
"I was in the bathroom. What did I miss?"
Rueben patted some more dust from his pants.
"Where to start?
A giant time monster attacked us."
"Can we save the memoir for after we grab the other sample?"
Rueben Z impatiently interrupted as he climbed back into the space and time capsule.
"Can we wait a minute?"
"Best we get this done as soon as possible. Don't want the virus mutating further and finding a way to hop worlds on its own, now do we?"
Okay.
Rueben turned to Buzz. You got any more of those special glass vials?
Buzz indicated the capsule, and Rueben Z raised a padded bag containing two vials.
One for each of you, Buzz said, in case something happens to one of them.
Rueben nodded. Buzz continued.
The virus at Ground Zero might not be visible to the human eye like this super-evolved dust version of it. In fact, you might have to swab a sample up and put that in the vial. I don't know, though. Maybe you'll get lucky and Ground Zero will be a biohazard spill or something visible.
How will we know where Ground Zero is? Rueben asked.
The virus detector should light up like crazy, Buzz said.
Rueben Z raised the cell phone-sized Gauss meter-like device in one hand while he irritably tapped the space and time capsule's center console.
Yes, yes, we already know that. Now, can we please get going?
Rueben turned to leave, but faced Aki before he got in.
I love you, and I'll be back.
For a moment, he got lost in her dark eyes. Then they kissed, long and hard. He didn't want to leave her. When he pulled back from her, he saw the same longing in her eyes.
You sure you have to go back? She asked. What if something goes wrong and you can't return to this earth?
Rueben looked down at the floor, then back at her.
I'll be okay. I wish there were another way, but we have to get the other virus sample so we can destroy the virus.
I know.
Aki reached up and trailed a finger through Ruben's hair.
Seriously, be safe, okay?
Rueben nodded with a smile. Then he got into the capsule. As he was harnessing himself in, Buzz stepped forward again.
Some important cautions before you go back to Earth-Z and warp back to find Ground Zero. Whatever you do, do not engage with young Rueben Z or anyone else who's part of Team Z. You could inadvertently affect the future timeline on Earth-Z, okay? Got it? No visiting Earth-Z's version of ourselves.
Rueben nodded seriously. Buzz turned to Rueben Z.
Yeah, yeah, Rueben Z said. Scout's honor and all that bullshit.
Rueben shook his head.
It's okay. I'll look after Rueben Z. He might not have told us about the virus monster waiting for us on Earth-Z, but he did save our asses. I'm not sure we would have gotten that first sample without his help. Anything else we need to be wary of? Yes, Buzz said. Absolutely no warping until I finish some tests.
Rueben Z smirked. I thought you guys took away my warping powers. He laughed. It annoyed Rueben. Hopefully he didn't kill Rueben Z on this little mission. Buzz disregarded Rueben Z.
No warping, okay? Under no circumstances can you die and warp backward until I do my testing. We want to undo this virus, not mutate it further. Can you imagine if the virus learned how to warp back in time?
Got it, Rueben said. How about we formally add two more rules to Buzz's rules for repeaters? One, no dying for either of us, especially Rueben Z, and two, no dying. Buzz scratched his forehead.
Buddy, that's only one rule.
Rueben chuckled. Yeah, but, you know, Fight Club? The two rules, but they were the same thing.
I don't have time to watch frivolous movies,
Buzz scoffed. Rueben tapped his fingers on his lap, turning serious again. He swallowed.
This no warping thing sucks big time.
He caught Martha's eye from across the room next to the monitor displaying the satellite feed.
Hey, how do things topside look? The virus still isn't on this Earth, right?
The brief look of concern that Martha and Aki exchanged worried Rueben, but then the two women smiled and shook their heads.
All good, babe,
Aki said. Martha scratched behind her head.
Yep, we thought we saw something earlier, but it was nothing. Just some weird trees.
Phew. That's good to hear. Can we stop talking and start hopping?
Rueben Z growled.
Oh, and one more thing. Buzz said. Once you hop to Earth-Z and time jump back to before the tanker incident in the space and time capsule, if for some reason shit hits the fan, you two are basically on your own. To get a message to us, you'll need to go to Earth-Z's version of the Paper Warriors newspaper office and send a message out to all the worlds by punching the green button.
Green button? Rueben asked.
Yeah, I called the Paper Warriors office yesterday. Man, those workers are complete morons. Don't even know how the printing press works. They make copies of the papers it spits out from other worlds and sell them. What I was able to ascertain from both your and their descriptions of the machine, all you have to do is make sure the date and time configuration is set for today on Earth A, and presumably hit the green button.
Buzz scribbled down the current Earth A date and time, adding a few hours for Carolyn and Marshall to arrive at the newspaper office.
Also, my tests should be conclusive by then on whether or not you can safely start warping again.
Rueben nodded.
Good to know. I never thought I'd say this, but I'm itching to die.
His friends all made sour faces.
It's okay, Rueben said. We don't plan on anything going wrong.
No one ever does, Buzz said. No one ever does.
Rueben Z growled and turned to Rueben.
Ready, cowboy?
Rueben bid his team a final goodbye and reached up to close the capsule's lid.
Remember, no warping and no interacting with yourselves.
Rueben Z smirked at Buzz.
That sounded dirty.
Everyone in the lab shook their heads as the space and time capsule's lid clicked closed.
Why?
Martha asked, her voice muffled by the glass lid.
What would happen if they interacted with their Earth-Z selves?
That, Buzz said, could mess up the future on Earth-Z, which could in turn have consequences in regards to how the virus first infected Rueben-Z. Also, it sounds like a bad idea. We don't know if there could be any other consequences we haven't thought of. Stay away from Earth-Z's versions of ourselves unless it's the absolute last option, okay?
From inside the capsule, Rueben nodded. Aki rushed forward and pressed her palm against the capsule's outer glass window, and Rueben matched hers against his side of the glass. For a long moment, they met each other's eyes. Then Buzz pulled Aki backward. The space and time capsule began to vibrate. Then it was gone.
Chapter 3. Earth-Z.
With Rueben Z operating the controls, they hopped first to Earth-Z's present time, which was 20 years in the future by Earth-A's standards, and promptly warped back in time on Earth-Z before the time virus monster could find them. At least that's what Rueben Z had said he was doing. Pitch blackness pressed in on the glass lid of the capsule.
Are you sure you know what you're doing? Rueben asked.
You didn't warp us back to before the Big Bang or something, did you?
Ha ha. We're good.
Rueben waited as the capsule's vibrations ceased. He tried to discern where they were through the glass lid, but he still couldn't see anything. Were they inside a building or a thick forest at night or something? What the hell? He turned to Rueben Z.
What did you do? Is this some trick? What happened?
Rueben Z laughed.
Don't get your panties in a bind. We're good.
We're good? What the hell is that supposed to mean? Where are we?
Suddenly, a fat drop of sludgy water smacked the top of the capsule's glass lid. Another drop fell, then another. Rueben Z smirked as he withdrew two penlights from his pants pockets. Rueben accepted his light and played it at the windshield. They were in a dark, stone-walled enclosure, and brownish liquid was dripping on top of them.
Are we in a sewer?
Very perceptive. Yes, we are.
That's disgusting.
It's also one of the safest places we could store the space and time capsule. We don't want people snooping around it, now do we? If they tampered with it, you could be trapped here. Nobody's coming down in this section of the sewer except the rats.
Rueben scratched behind his head. It was a rather smart place to appear in the past on Earth-Z. It would have completely blown their cover if they had appeared on the sidewalk somewhere, as they had on present-day Earth-Z.
If I get shit dripped on my head when I climb out of this capsule...
Rueben Z made a dismissive gesture.
Look, if you decide to stay in this line of work on your Earth when this is all over, you'll have a lot worse than shit dripped on your head. What's that supposed to mean? Shit isn't so bad, is what I mean. Now shut up and get out. Don't forget to take the virus detector and your glass vial. Rueben growled. Who did this prick think he was, taking control like this? Don't forget, this is my Earth, Rueben Z said, as if reading Rueben's mind. I know my way around better than you. You might want to follow my lead. Rueben raised a hand irritably. You're the biggest... He let his breath out in a big sigh. Fine. You get to lead. As long as you remember what Buzz said, absolutely no interaction with your old friends and family. They can't know we're here, or the virus timeline might get messed up beyond repair. Rueben Z nodded solemnly and made an X gesture across his chest. Cross my heart and hope to die, yada yada, etc. Now come on. Wait, Rueben said. We went back to before the tanker incident. So how many years ahead in the future are we, compared to Earth A? About 15 years. Now come on. They popped the lid and climbed out of the capsule. Rueben grabbed the virus detector and his vial and handed Rueben Z his vial. Luckily, the equipment was small and easily concealable in their clothes. Clothes. As he closed the space and time capsule's lid, Rueben briefly wondered what people wore on Earth Z since they were technically 15 years in the future in regard to Earth A. Ahead of him, Rueben Z lit the way through the sewer with his penlight. Coming, princess! Fuck this guy. Rueben hurried after the man. Where are we going? Rueben observed the stone of the sewer tunnel as they walked. So far, Earth Z looked the same as Earth A. Not that Rueben ever frequented the sewers on Earth A, but it looked like an ordinary sewer. He wondered if the people on Earth Z would look different. Would there be any other differences here since the timeline on Earth Z was 20 years ahead of Earth A? First off, Rueben Z said, we're going to get a change of clothes. Then we're going to follow up on a lead as to where Ground Zero might be. Rueben scoffed. We just got here, and you already have a plan and a lead? I've been doing this for a long time. Being an asshole? Ha, funny. What I mean is I'm well trained and know how to run a good op. It's something you'll eventually learn if you stay with the CIA. Also, Aki will teach you a lot too. Being a special agent, she has a lot of experience. Rueben Z sighed and added, almost as an afterthought, the other thing I mean is that I've been planning for this day for a long time. I knew that once I found a buzz on a parallel Earth that could help me defeat the time virus, I'd have to eventually come back to Earth Z before the virus's wanton destruction. Let's just say you're lucky to have me. I have all my ducks in a row. Rueben ran one of his hands along the perspiring stone wall beside him. I'll have to take your word for it. For all I know, you're stringing me along, bullshitting me. Rueben Z turned and faced Rueben in the dim sewer, their penlights the only source of light. He jabbed his finger into Ruben's chest. This mission is about saving my family. I don't bullshit about family. Okay, okay. Lead on. It's just, how do you know we're far enough back in this Earth's timeline before the time virus mutates? How far back did you even go? Rueben Z had insisted on manning the controls since he was the only one of them who had ever piloted a space and time capsule. Rueben Z started walking. Buzz said he thinks my infection most likely took place before the tanker mission, which is the first distorted place in my nanobot footage. Today is currently 5 days prior. You think that's enough time? What if the incubation period is longer than 5 days? What if young Rueben Z is already infected? Rueben Z spun. Don't question me, all right? And can we stop referring to me or this Earth's younger version of me as Rueben Z? It's degrading. What do you want me to call you? If we each call each other Rueben, that might get confusing. How about God? What about RZ? Rueben asked.
Rueben Z considered it. He laughed.
Simple. And badass, like me. How about we go with Z, and we call this Earth's younger version of me Young Z? Those sound like rapper names. Who said I'm not a rapper?
Z gave a tight sneer.
Me, because I'm you and I don't rap. Please,
Z barked. You're a parallel knockoff of me. We're not the same person. We're from different worlds, with our own destinies.
Rueben crossed his arms.
Whatever, asshole. Prove it.
What, that I can rap? I don't have to prove shit to you.
Rueben made a fist and released it.
Can we please keep moving?
No.
No?
Z pointed at a metal ladder welded against the sewer's stone wall.
We're here.
They replaced the heavy sewer grate at the top and surveyed the room they were in. Rueben thought they might emerge on the street somewhere, but they were in a dark room filled with pipes, ventilation shafts, and HVAC equipment.
Where are we? Follow my lead, okay?
I don't like blindly following a man who once kidnapped me, put me in a coma, and locked me in a basement for 3 days.
Can we let bygones be bygones?
No!
Z threw his hands up. I was out of my mind, okay? The time disease was screwing me up inside. You want to blame me for my actions? Fine, but it's all spilled milk.
That's rich, Rueben said.
That's rich,
Z mimed.
Asshole, bitch.
Rueben growled, and Z laughed.
I'll toughen you up yet.
Rueben lunged forward with a fist, and Z easily caught it and shoved it to the side. Z had an easy opening, but didn't take it. Rueben, however, followed up with a surprise left hook and caught Z on the mouth. Z pulled back his lip to reveal blood sluicing over the whites of his teeth. He swallowed the blood.
Nice one. I deserved that.
Rueben took another swing. Z sidestepped and caught the fist, maneuvering behind Rueben and twisting his arm up. When Rueben grunted, Z chuckled.
I'll let you have that first one, but you're not going to get another one. We're on the same team, remember?
Don't remind me, Rueben thought. This mission couldn't be over soon enough for him. He hoped he didn't kill Z first. There was a metal door up ahead. Z stepped toward it and placed his hand on the knob.
You ready to meet Earth Z?
He threw open the door. Chapter 4. Earth Z. People milled past the door in dense groups. Families, teenagers, mall cops.
Mall cops?
Rueben squinted against the sunlight pouring in through the skylight.
Your sewer exit led us here? We're in a mall? What better place to get clothes so we can fit in?
Z inhaled deeply.
Ah, the smell of giant soft pretzels, fresh baked cookies, and
overpriced kiosk perfumes?
You're no fun.
Z entered the throng of people coursing back and forth in the mall complex. Rueben recognized the layout of this exact mall from Earth A. But most of the stores had different names, not surprising considering they were 15 years into the future. Also, this was a parallel Earth, so there were bound to be some small differences. He turned his attention to the people and noticed most wore fashionable jogging-style pants and form-fitting hooded jackets. Many of them wore sleek-looking sunglasses, even though they were inside a building. Rueben glanced down at his and Z's clothes, which had been contemporary on Earth A.
Yeah, dressed like this, they only drew attention to themselves.
Z seemed to know where he was going, so Rueben followed him through the mall until he stopped in front of a soft pretzel vendor tucked into the wall. Z turned to Rueben.
Buy me a pretzel, will you?
I'm not buying you a... Z thrust out his hand and dropped some bills into Rueben's hands.
Get you something, too. Don't want to work a mission on an empty stomach, right?
Rueben felt there was something more to the request. Was this a test?
We need clothes, not food.
Z shook his head.
First food, then clothes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.